Hi guys, welcome to another video. Welcome to another Shopify feature release video. So Dawn theme 14.0.0 has been released. And in this video, I'm going to show you guys what are the latest feature which they added. I'm your host Bilal Naseer, and let's walk through what are the latest feature which they added in Dawn 14.0.0. Okay guys, so as you can see on my screen, these are the features which they added. We will be going through all of the added feature which is in Dawn 14.0.0 and what are some of the features which they changed. Okay, now let's first check this out. They have added the new quick add bulk functionality which can be added to the product grid and featured collection sections. Now let's see what is that basically. So we have this featured product showing up on my homepage. And now if you go to customize settings and click on featured collection section and scroll down, you have this option of quick add, where if you click on standard, you can show this choose option button with the products which have variants. So what it will do basically, so let me save it and go back to the home page. So it will basically, when you click on choose option, it will give you an pop-up which will show option of all of the variations. Now let's see what we have on the third option. Let's go back to customize and click on bulk. And now click on save and let's preview that. Now we have the option to bulk add the variants just like this. And this is also keyboard friendly. So if you're using this in mobile version, it's super responsive and keyboard optimized as we're showing up here, and it will improve the bulk buying flow. So that is this feature which they added in Dawn 14.0.0. Now let's go through the other feature which they added. So in this, they have added sign in with Shop. So Shopify has an Android and iOS app which you can add on your mobiles, which is basically like a marketplace. And the website for it is like shop.app. That's the website URL for that. And the app is available by the name of Shop. Its own Shopify app. What it will do, that it will list all of the products which are available in all of the Shopify stores, which has Shopify app installed on their Shopify stores. So let me show you what this feature will basically do is it will give your buyers to sign in using that Android or iOS app. So how you can add that feature on your Shopify store, all you have to do is just search for Shopify app. And that's the app. I think that's the correct one. Yep. So that's the app which is available for you to install on your Shopify store. And when you install that on your Shopify store, your store products will be available on all of the Androids and iOS app which is being added by the potential buyer. So they can see all of the products from multiple stores within that Android or iOS app. So that's a pretty cool feature, and you can now they can simply sign in using their Shop Pay account. So that's the feature which they added in Dawn 14.0.0. And now let's move on to the third feature which they added, which is the classic customer account login page now includes a sign in with Shop. Now let me show you where they added it. Now let's go back to customize and click on this drop down and click on this classic customer accounts and then click on customer login and then click on this login here. Here you have the option to enable sign in with Shop. So if your customer click on the customer account icon on your Shopify store or click login, they will have the option to sign in using the Shop app which they have in the Android or iOS app. So that's this feature. Now let's move on to the changed feature. So in this, they have added, now you can add filters, add images to your filters. I couldn't find that on filter because I think that feature was already available. So I have created a detailed video on how you can create meta objects. Link will be in the description. Using meta objects, you can create additional filters, and in those filters, you can display images and you can also display swatches. Let me show you how. So I'm going to click on exit and click on apps and go to search and discovery app. By the way, search and discovery app is the free Shopify app, and all of the filters in your store is managed by search and discovery app. I have already created a separate video for that. Link will be in the description where you can learn how you can use search and discovery app. So what you will basically do is first create a meta object. Then using the search and discovery app, you can add custom filters which will display color swatches and which will display images. So let's go to this app and where's this app showing up? Okay, here in search and discovery, we have this filters. Now what I'm gonna do, I'll add images in my filter and add swatches on my filters. Again, I'm not showing you guys how you can create meta objects and display in search and discovery app. You can learn about meta objects in the other video which I've already created. It's a pretty detailed video which will give you a step-by-step process on how you can create meta objects and how you can create entries and how you can display those meta objects using meta fields. So that's a different video which I've already created. Link will be in the description. For now, we will just add images and swatches to filters using meta objects and search and discovery app. So click on add filter and I'm going to search for the meta object here which I have already created by the name of creators, and you can see currently it's showing swatches. So let's see how it's gonna look. So I'm going to click on save and then I'm gonna go back to my store and go to my all products collection page, and here I have this filter showing up, which is showing up because I added it now in front of you guys using search and discovery app. Now when I click on that, you can see that it's showing color swatch. The reason why it's showing just one because I haven't added the value. Now let me add the value as well to display all these three color swatches. So I'm going to quickly add the value of these. I know it's a little bit confusing because it's an in-depth tutorial about meta objects. You guys will have to check out that other video which I created. It's going to help you guys understanding how those meta objects and meta fields will work. It's not that hard. It's just that you'll have to do a little practice with that in order to be familiar. Okay, now if I click on creators, now you can see we have these color swatches available. Now, as per Dawn 14.0.0 documentation, they're saying that they can now include images. Now let's switch our display option in search and discovery app to image. And now click on done. Now click on save. And now let's go back to our all products collection, hit refresh. And now in creators, we have images showing up as our filters. I'm not sure about this point 100% because what I think is, as far as I remember, that this feature was already there, but I'm not sure if that's the feature which they added. But let me know in the comments below if you actually know what this feature is where they're saying that filters can now include images. Okay, the next feature which we'll be discussing is the quick order list section. So it's basically they added the keyboard support navigation for the quick order list section, which shows up on the product page. So if you go to customize and go to your product page template from this drop down here and click on add section, we have this quick order list section, which looks like this. So let's move it here. And that's the section where they added functionality for keyboard navigation, for better keyboard navigation. And now let's move on to the next one, which is the maximum number of products per page has been increased to 36. Previously, we were not able to add in products more than 24 products in the collection page. So let me show you the difference between Dawn 13.0.1 and Dawn 14.0.0. So that's our customized settings. And if I click on this drop down to go to the collection page, here is the collection page. And in the product grid, we have now option to display 36 products per page. I currently only have 5 products, but now we can display 36 products per page. Previously, it was less than that. I think we were not able to display 24 products, more than 24 products. So let's check that out in the older version of Dawn theme. So I'm going to go to my backend because I already have the Dawn 13.0.1. I keep saying that. Sorry about that. Okay, online store. And that's the 13.0.0. Where's the 13.0.1? Okay, that's the 13.0.1. And if we go to customize settings of 13.0.1 and go to our collection page, in product grid, we can display maximum of 24 products. And in Dawn 14.0.0, we have the ability to get it 36 product on one single page. So that's the feature which they added. In multi-column collection list and product grids, related product and related product section, they have increased the number of columns to be 6. So let's compare that as well. So I'm going to add a multi-column section. Let's click on add section, click on multi-column. And here, number of columns on desktop, let's move it to 6. Now let's check out in Dawn 13.0.1. I'm going to add multi-column list section on 13.0.1 as well to compare it for you guys. And in here, okay, it's the same. Then what did they change? Related products have an increased maximum of 6 columns. I don't see any difference here. So Dawn 13.0.1 also showing up 6 columns. Can we add it here? So let's try adding a block. 5, 6. Yes, that's not a problem. We can add as many blocks as we want. It's just, it will display 6 columns in this section and it's in multi-column. Let's check out the collection list. So I'm gonna go back to homepage and let's check it on product grid. So I'm on collection list page and here we can display number of columns 5 in the desktop. And this is Dawn 13.0.1. Now let's check the collection list page on Dawn 14.0.0. So I'm gonna go to collection list here. And yeah, that's the difference I can see. In previous version, we had option of 5 columns displaying as collection list. But in the latest version, we are now seeing it as 6 columns. Now we can add 6 column layout in collection list and similarly with the product grids and related products. So in product grids, let's check out for Dawn 13.0.1. So I'm gonna go to product page template to see how many columns 13.0.1 had before. And that's where can we find the product grid section? I think it's in default collection page. Yes, it's in default collection page. So that's our product grid. And if we click on product grid, we had 5 number of columns to display in the desktop version. And in Dawn 14.0.0, they have 6 columns. Now let's go to 14.0.0 and click on product grid. And they have 6 columns. And that's it guys. So these are the features which I have gone through with you guys in order to show you guys what are the latest feature in the Dawn 14.0.0 which you will be having. I don't think these features will affect most of the functionality. If you are still using Dawn 13.0.1 and you have a lot of customization, I suggest you guys not to update, because if you have customization and the code, it's not going to pass over automatically to Dawn 14.0.0, and there'll be a lot of hassle of transferring all of the custom code to the latest version. So I think let's keep it same as Dawn 13.0.1 until a new major release show up in the Shopify themes. And that's it for the video, guys. If you like the video, let me know in the comments below. Subscribe to my channel. I also have created previous feature release video as well.